Hello friends, this video on gravitation part 5 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exams. Please make sure that you have watched all the parts from 1 to 4 before going ahead with part 5. Let us suppose that this is our Earth. We want to calculate the value of acceleration due to gravity at some point which is at a distance h from the surface of the Earth. Let us suppose we want to calculate the value at some point P, which is at a distance h from the surface of the Earth. Now this is the center of the Earth. So this distance is Re, that is the radius of the Earth. So from this point till the center, this is the radius and this is the object which is located at a height h. And let us suppose the mass of this object is m1. m1 is the mass of the object, or m is the mass of the object, let us say. Not to complicate it further, we say that m is the mass of this object. Fine. Now, here also let us try to calculate the force of gravitation between this object m and the Earth. The force of gravitation on this object M due to Earth will be capital G M1 M2 divided by R square. What is R? R is the distance between the two objects. That means distance of this object M from Earth. So what will be that distance? Re plus H. So this would be Re plus H whole square. Right? So this is the force of gravitation on the object M due to the Earth. So we can say what would be the value of G. Now again here we are calculating G of H. That means the value of G at a height H above the surface of the Earth. So this value, so G will be equal to F by M. That means this will be equal to GME divided by RE plus h whole square, right? Now in this case, let us suppose we take out Re as a common. So this would be 1 plus h by Re whole square. Right? So we have taken out Re common from inside. So I am left with 1 plus h by Re whole square. Now let us, if you think it very practically, this distance h will be very small when compared to the radius of the Earth. You imagine this scenario in real life. Radius of the Earth. Earth is so huge. So radius of the Earth is also very huge. But when we consider the height of an object from the surface of the Earth, that will be very small when compared to the radius of the Earth. That means this h will be very, very small when compared to the radius of the Earth. Therefore, we can apply binomial theorem. How do we apply binomial theorem? We can write the above expression as gme divided by re square. This you leave as it is. So this into 1 plus h by re to the power minus 2, because I took it to the numerator. Now since h is very, very less than Re, that means this entire term will be very, very less than 1. That means it will be a very small term. So in this case we can apply binomial expansion. So we will expand it binomially. So how do we expand something binomially? The binomial expansion says, binomial expansion, you must have studied all these things in your mathematics. Binomial expansion says that 1 plus x to the power n can be written as 1 plus nx plus n into n minus 1 by factorial 2 x square and so on. Right, this is how the binomial expansion is done. So in this case, since h is very, very less than Re, we can expand this term binomially. But we will consider only the first two terms. We will neglect the higher terms. So expanding this in binomially, so what do we get? We get gme by Re square. This we will leave as it is. and this will be 1 plus nx. What is n here? N is minus 2. So this will be 1 minus 2 and x is h by re. So this would be this. Now, as I already told you previously also, what is gme by re square? It is nothing but the value of acceleration due to gravity g on the surface of the earth. So this would be g into 1 minus 2h by re. Now, what is this? What were we calculating? We were calculating the value of g at a height h above the surface of the earth. So we saw that how does the value of acceleration due to gravity varies on the surface of the earth, above the surface of the earth, and below the surface of the earth. So I hope it is clear to you. See, in this case, in the derivations, we are doing nothing but applying simple mathematics. All you need to do is, it is very much important to learn and to remember these formulas. Deriving this formula is not a big deal, because once you understand the mathematics which we are using behind this, it will be very easy for you to derive such things. But remembering the formula is important so that you can solve the problems quicker and easier. Thank you. Please visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thank you once again.